Overview: having debuted more than half a decade ago, the Hyundai Santa Fe is an elder statesman among midsize crossover SUVs. Sharing its key chassis componentry with the smaller Santa Fe Sport, the Santa Fe sits on a 3.9-inch greater wheelbase and measures 8.1 inches longer stem to stern. The extra size provides the Santa Fe with enough room for a third row with seating for two. Available in base SE, mid-level SE Ultimate, and top-spec Limited Ultimate trims, every Santa Fe is motivated by a 290 HP 3.3-liter V6 engine paired with a 6-speed automatic transmission. Front-wheel drive is standard, while all-wheel drive is available for $1,750, the Santa Fe also can tow up to 5,000 pounds. Starting at $31,800, the Santa Fe SE comes standard with seating for 7, dual-zone automatic climate control, a power driver's seat, a 7.0-inch touchscreen infotainment system with Apple CarPlay and Android Auto compatibility, and 18-inch wheels. A $3,650 premium package adds active safety items such as blind spot monitoring and lane keeping assist, as well as features like a proximity key with push-button start, leather upholstery, heated front seats, a power liftgate, and LED fog lights. Moving up to the $39,800 Santa Fe SE Ultimate includes everything in the SE's premium package and brings additional items such as a 360-degree camera, a panoramic sunroof, a heated steering wheel, heated rear seats, ventilated front seats, an 8.0-inch infotainment touchscreen, and 19-inch wheels. The $2,100 tech package adds adaptive cruise control, automated emergency braking, lane departure warning, HID headlights with automatic high beams, and an electric parking brake. Finally, the $40,500 Limited Ultimate tops things off by adding memory for the power driver's seat, rear parking sensors, and second row bucket seats in place of a 3-across bench, which reduces seating capacity to 6. The same $2,100 tech package offered in the SE Ultimate also can be added here, which, along with all-wheel drive, brought our Limited Ultimate test car's final tally to $44,350. What's new? Following last year's refresh, the Santa Fe enters 2018 with a handful of minor updates. Most notably, the mid-range Limited trim has been deleted from the lineup. Additionally, Hyundai now gives Santa Fe customers access to its Blue Link telematics service for 3 years, free of charge. Among the services bundled into Blue Link are automatic collision notification and access to the Blue Link remote services app. What we like: exceptionally smooth and relatively quiet, the Santa Fe rides as though its springs were made of clouds. Whether traversing the Midwest's weather-beaten tarmac or hustling down dirt roads, the Santa Fe remains as cushy and composed as it does when cruising on polished pavement. Additionally, we appreciate the easy-to-use and quick-responding touchscreen infotainment system that's standard in every Santa Fe. Our test car featured the larger 8.0-inch unit, but prior experience with the standard 7.0-inch touchscreen left us with positive impressions as well. What we don't like: even though crossover SUVs aren't meant to be sports cars, we appreciate some level of driving enjoyment from these big boxes. Unfortunately, no hint of driving pleasure is to be found behind the Santa Fe's steering wheel. Its overboosted steering, excessive body roll, and proclivity toward understeer even at relatively low speeds give the Santa Fe the dynamics of a minivan without the extra space and versatility. On the subject of space, the Santa Fe's 80 cubic feet of cargo volume with both the second and third rows of seats folded flat trails competitors such as the Chevrolet Traverse by 18 cubic feet and the Volkswagen Atlas by 17. The Santa Fe's dashboard also suffers from an outdated and button-intensive design, and the interior overall has more hard plastic than we'd like.